Hello guys, first of all, a very happy new year to all of you. I'm very excited to meet all after a very long break. In this video, I'm going to explain about data visualization, which is the most crucial part in data science. Imagine if you have a massive amount of data in the form of Excel sheets. Would you be able to find any patterns or trends in the data? Obviously not. That's where the data visualization comes into picture. If you want to tell some stories or get a meaning out of data, data visualization definitely helps. In this video, I'm going to explain about what type of data visualization you can do based upon the functionality. Basically, data visualization is a graphical representation of information and data. It helps you to tell stories. These graphical representation may be charts, graphs, or maps that helps you to identify the patterns, trends, outliers in the massive amount of data. It is very essential to combine the results of the data analysis and the data visualization. So, remember, it is very important to focus on extracting the meaning from the massive amount of data rather than focusing on producing the colorful charts and graphs. Let's see the data visualization based on the functionality. So, as I told, you can use different type of visualization, depends on what you want to do with the data. Most common type of visualizations are bar graphs and pie charts. The most general type of visualization can include charts, graphs, tables and maps. To turn your numbers into knowledge, you just need four basic methods of visualization, which include comparison, composition, distribution and relationship. The example use cases for each type of visualization and also what type of charts and graphs has been used for each method of visualization. Okay, let's see what is comparison. As the name suggests, it helps you to compare values of two or more data points. If you want to know how a particular data set has been performed over a period of time, you can go for this type of visualization. It helps you to find the lowest and highest values in the charts. It also helps you to find the patterns, which can be your trends, outliers, gaps or spikes. Some of the example use cases for this type of visualization may be the annual revenue for product lines, or yearly or quarterly or half yearly product sales, or total number of visitors or customers per month or for any specific period of time. You can use line charts, bar charts or column charts for this type of visualization. Next, we are going to see about composition. As the name suggests, if you want to show the total values in the form of parts or division, you can use this type of visualization. It helps you to find the significant part that makes up the whole value. The most common use cases for this type of visualization include the showing the total number of population based on the religion, ethnic groups or the languages, or it can be total revenue made by the product lines based on the region or the division. For this type of visualization, you can use pie or donut charts, or stacked bar or column charts, or stacked area charts. Okay, let's see what is distribution. Distribution combines the functionality of both the composition and the comparison. It helps you to find what are the related and unrelated items in the data set. It also helps you to find the trends, patterns, outliers, and also the shapes, averages, and the correlations in the data items. Example use cases which use this type of visualization includes if you want to visualize the distribution of ages in the people group, or if you want to visualize the sales performance in different stores, or to spot the highest or lowest performing stores, you can go for this type of visualization. You can also use this visualization to spot bugs in the quality or production control systems. For this type of visualization, the commonly used chart types include column and bar histogram charts, or line and area charts, or scatter plot charts, data tables and map charts. Okay, next we are going to see about the relationship. As the name suggests, it helps to find the relationship between the two or more variables. It helps how a particular variable is positively or negatively affecting the another variable. It is very similar to distribution, which helps to find the relationship between the correlations, patterns, trends or outliers. Okay, examples for this type of visualization include estimating how the marketing expenditure is affecting the sales or profit, or does the income level depends on the IQ, or do the top tier business school graduates are earning more in their careers. So these are some of the questions that you can able to answer. The chart types which are used for this type of visualization include scatter plots, which can be of two dimension, or bubble charts, which can be three or four dimensions, or line charts, or lines with two or more axes, and table charts. So these are some of the commonly used chart types for a relationship type of visualization. Basically, bar charts are good for comparisons, line charts are good for showing trends and relationship, and scatter plots good for showing relationship and distributions. Pie charts can be used for composition, never for comparisons or distribution. There may be overlaps. The choice for data visualization includes many other factors, which can be how many variables you want to show, whether you want to show one, two or many variables, or how many items for each variable you want to display, one, two or many, or how will you be displaying the values for a specific period of time, or based on items or groups. So these are the factors that you need to consider before deciding the data visualization type. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like the video, subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon for the future videos. If you have any queries or comments, please write it in the comment section. Thank you so much. See you later.